While domestic helpers in Hong Kong fear job loss and abuse amid the COVID crisis, one recruitment agency believes manpower prospects can improve with the expansion in digital engagement with employers and workers. For more on that, joining us from Hong Kong is Mahi Leclerc of Helper Choice. Mahi, good morning and thank you for joining us.
Hi, good morning.
Hi, Mahi, Helper's Choice. What services does it provide and how can it help during these times of crisis?
So actually, Helper Choice is a platform to connect people looking for a job as a foreign domestic worker with employers in Hong Kong and also in Singapore. And the goal of the platform, we were launched in 2012, is to not charge any fee for the people looking for a job. So that is a good thing because using traditional agencies, a lot of people actually applying for jobs as a foreign worker in Hong Kong have to pay high amount of fees. So that way they don't have to pay anything and they don't have to pay to take a loan to actually after reimburse these fees. And during COVID right now, we've seen a lot of people actually having seen their contract terminated. And what we do is that we try to help them as much as possible to find a new job so they can just register to the platform if they're already in Hong Kong. And our team will call them back and help them build a good profile to find a job as soon as possible.
Mm-hmm. That's so nice hearing that those who are affected in Hong Kong, if they do lose their jobs, they can just register over the website. Is that correct? So they won't be needing to pay any hefty fees.
No, they don't have to pay any fee. So also, it's a good thing in Hong Kong because the Hong Kong government actually put in place temporary measures for people that have seen their contract terminated or are finishing their contracts right now. They can extend their visa, so that gives them more time to find another job before having to go back to the Philippines, for example. Mm-hmm. So if they actually register on the platform and build their CV on there, and they can directly contact employers, and we will help them find a new employer.
Mm-hmm. Mahi, the pandemic gave rise to digitalization of many things. You've already mentioned that they just have to register. I would want to know what other kinds of workers can Helper's Choice give more assistance with? Is it just domestic helpers or are there other jobs aside from that?
No, right now the platform is only for domestic workers.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. All right. What's the difference between Helper's Choice and traditional hiring agencies?
Well, first, they can do everything online. So right now with the COVID situation, most of the people registering are in Hong Kong already, but they can also register if they're in the Philippines. And as I said, we do not charge any fee. Mm-hmm. And we also can provide support. So what we do is in Hong Kong, we post a lot of information about the regulations, their rights, so that they can either know them better or share them with their employers. And in case of emergency, if they require some help at some point, they can reach out to us and we'll refer them to some NGOs here locally to help them, whether it is for like financial support, legal support, or also pregnancy rights.
Mm-hmm. That's a very good thing that you're doing for the Filipino workers. Well, it's not just Filipino workers that you're helping, right, if I'm not mistaken. Can you please take me into the process of how you recruit workers?
So actually, it's very simple. Mm-hmm. It's a platform that is free to use for everyone. So the workers can actually just register on the platform. They do it by themselves. They can do it on their phones. If they have any issue, they can contact us on Facebook or call them directly. Call us directly. Mm-hmm. They just have to fill out a form requiring a lot of information, like their nationality, where they are at the moment, their skills. They can build their own resume, and then they post it. And once they posted, the idea is that the whole process is online and they can actually be very autonomous in finding a new job. Mm-hmm. So we don't charge anything and they can just see all the employers that are in Hong Kong that maybe ask for someone that has the skills that they have, and they can contact them directly, and then they can be in touch with the employers directly and send them messages and everything.
Mm-hmm. Mahi, with this kind of digitalization, is this a temporary thing that you see for the workers, or can they find a means of financial opportunity that could last a long time with Helper's Choice?
Well, what we see right now is that we were actually the first ones providing this service in Hong Kong, and we're still the leading platform, but we've seen a lot of other agencies actually going online to provide this seamless experience for both the people looking for a job and for the employers in Hong Kong looking for someone. The ethical side of it, of course, is a big part. The fact that we do not have to charge the workers anymore that for them to find a job is very important. We don't think it's a trends. We've seen, especially employers in Hong Kong, are now using online services more and more, where before they were going to traditional agencies. Actually, we've seen a rise in the use of the platform, especially with the COVID situation because of social distancing lately.
Mahi, of course, these workers would still have to have visas in order for them to work. Is Helper's Choice coordinating with the Philippine embassies and the Hong Kong government to help our workers process their visas as well?
So actually right now, most of the people on the platform are already in Hong Kong, so they already have a visa that they can extend during the situation. When they come from abroad, we cannot process the visas by ourselves at the moment. We are actually applying to a new accreditation to be able to do that and to control the whole process. And right now, how we work is once they matched with someone and they found an employer, we refer the employer to a partner agency that do not charge the worker anything, and the employer takes care of all the fees for the visa.
Now, I'm kind of concerned about guaranteeing the safety for both parties, for the employers and also for the health workers. Do you have like a screening process going on, and can both parties get to review at least the security papers or security details of who they're hiring and who they're going to be going to?
Yeah, we do. Actually, it's one of the main questions that we have as a digital service, right? Because you want to be able to know that this person has been verified. So what we do is that we have our team that is reviewing all the ads, whether on the employer side or on the domestic worker side, to make sure that the ads are legitimate, actually. And then when it comes to the IDs and the identity, they have to give us their passport, Hong Kong ID, and current visa if relevant. And we also, for the workers, they can ask to be verified. So we verify their informations furthermore, and we verify their trainings as well. And then we have our customer support team calling them and helping them build their resume to help them find a job. Also, when they input their experience right now, the employers can review the workers if they already work with them before, and we're planning to also put a review for the workers to review the employers so that it's a, you know, both sides situation.
Mahi, what about for those who already have gotten jobs through Helper's Choice? Is there any means for your company to still be able to monitor what's happening for both parties?
So what we do right now is that we provide the platform, and after we don't really do the visa process. So they can still actually reach out to us if they have any question. That's something that happens a lot. If they have any question on the minimum salary, the allowable like wage, and also the food allowance or the rest days or any legal information that they need, we're here to support. What we also do is that we do a lot of surveys in Hong Kong about how they are impacted by things, for example, how they were impacted by the protests, how they are impacted by the COVID virus right now. We also make an annual salary survey to for them to know where in Hong Kong people have the highest salary as a domestic worker and what is the average that they can like renegotiate their salaries with their employer. So we try to do as much We try to get as much feedback as we can from the workers, and try to spread the word a bit larger after that.
With regard to salary payouts, do you also help with the employer and the worker with that? Or is how are their salaries being given to them?
So in Hong Kong, a lot of foreign domestic workers actually don't have a bank account, and that's something that we push for quite a lot towards the employers. So we do send a lot of content to the employers to tell them that their helper should actually have a bank account, because it gives more transparency and it's also easier for her to save money after. So that's one of the things we are trying to build right now, a way to for the employers to pay the worker directly on the platform, and then like put it on a bank account in Hong Kong. So we're looking for partners at the moment to actually build this new feature. Mm-hmm. And we also work with a great NGO in Hong Kong that is called Enrich Hong Kong. Mm-hmm. And that is specialized in financial literacy for foreign domestic workers, either from the Philippines or from Indonesia. And we are planning to provide some training with their help mm-hmm. in financial literacy for all the foreign workers to be able to better like have their goals set when it comes to saving money or sending money back.
Mm-hmm. All right. Mahi, thank you so much for helping our displaced Filipino workers and also the other domestic helpers, not just the Philippines here in Hong Kong, and also for taking the time to talk to us and explain this to us. God bless and do take care.
Thank you. Bye.